Well, a one-sided beatdown for Darren Hamilton. He returns, he retains his British light welterweight title with an easy win over Steve Williams. Paul, what did you see there?
Very convincing win for Darren Hamilton. For every possibility that Steve Williams would try to come with, he had an answer for. And it got to the point where you become a slave to the rhythm of getting hit, become conscious of something happening to you, even when it doesn't happen. He was very relaxed on the ropes. He was landing significant signature right uppercuts. Very convincing.
Tommy, we were talking round nine, they could have stopped this thing round nine, round 10 anytime.
Oh, yeah, at 10, I thought it was done. But, I mean, if you're Darren Hamilton, you're going to come out with a hat like that coming into the ring, you better perform. And he definitely did. He left no doubt in that ring.
That's a big win for Darren Hamilton, who they mentioned a couple times during the broadcast. He's one of the more known boxing guys in England, a guy who I know very well, Spencer Fearon, former fighter, promoter, manager, so he's got a good team around him. I know there's a guy I know fighting later in the evening, I know, over there. I know they mentioned that in the broadcast, who you're pretty impressed with, who may be fighting Hamilton coming up.
Yes, Adel Anwar. I watched him fight, had a couple of his matches, and very good lateral movement, and the one thing I like about his lateral movement is he makes you pay for when you overextend.
That could be a big fight to look to in the future, but the fight in the near future is coming up next. The big heavyweight fight, like we mentioned in the beginning, we have 500 pounds of heavyweights. We have Tony Thompson, 262 pounds. When you saw that, he's a guy who's in the high 240s, low 250s usually, mm-hmm. 262, Paul. I don't know.
I'm going to basically say that basically it was, you know, he's getting older now and maybe he, you know, that, to take it off to that. But I don't like when a fighter comes in at 262.
Well, so let's segue into the tail of the tape here. We'll see some of the statistics, the height, the weight, and, you know, we have 82-inch reach, 81. So that's not a big deal. What stands out for you, Paul?
Well, the 3-inch height, I mean, and once again, I'm going to the weight as far as, you know, you see Price comes in at 247, so, and, you know, he's a bigger guy. What stands out most is he's 15-0, but other than that, it's fact of the matter, 262.
I'll have to disagree with you. I think the big number that stands out there is the first number under Thompson.
41.
There you go, Tommy.
41?
41. Okay. I mean, 41 and age 29.
I'll go with undefeated. I'll take that.
We got the 2012 prospect of the year, according to ESPN, and we got a 41-year-old. So yeah. I agree with you, Mark. That's probably the stat that jumps out to me.
And so, you know, rehash some stuff that we may have talked about for some of our viewers who came in late. The stepping stone, the gatekeeper. You know, this is the first really big non-domestic name for David Price. We've been mentioning the comparisons with Tyson Fury. He got his domestic name already in Kevin Johnson.
Right.
Now it's his turn with Tony Thompson.
Yeah, it's his opportunity, like I said, for him to shine, for him to perform, to send a message to Tyson Fury and his camp and to the rest of the heavyweights, you know, who are ahead of him in the rankings. And let's be noted that Lennox Lewis has said that David Price is the heir apparent, and so he even endorses David Price. So that's some additional pressure.
And when Lennox says that, you know, that's almost like that's the British stamp of approval there. Now, you know, we'll take a look at some highlights of the last fight. You see Matt Skelton tried to rush Price, Paul.
And I thought that he would do that. Like I said, this was his opportunity, basically, to make a statement coming in off his other fights. But once again, look at the range. He takes a step back. I'm talking about David Price. Basically creates his real estate, checks it out. As you notice, it comes right under. It's covered up. And the thing is, notice he has his hand around, kind of creating, basically dominating the area, his real estate.
Well, with the hand, we talked about the hand around and everything like that. We mentioned before, Thompson, make this an ugly veteran fight. Use those type of tactics. As you see Skelton lowering his shoulder into Price, you know, do all that stuff that you've learned over your 15, 18, 20-year career.
Correct. But the only thing about that Skelton fight that I had predicted this would happen was he was significantly slower than I had seen on previous tapes. So I don't know if Tony Thompson is going to be that way.
You see now, I look at Price now. Is he a little too straight up, you think, at times?
European style, and a lot of people, I'm actually a fan of that because it keeps you, you tower over the individuals, and you're able to see things a lot easier.
Tommy, we just see the big right hand over there with Price.
Yeah, I mean, David Price, again, this is another short fight. This is only the last two rounds. I have a pretty good feeling, having seen it before, obviously. But, again, we mentioned in the opening, this will be interesting because Tony's only been knocked out twice, both to Klitschko. So this is going to go long. Dave's going to have to use that skill that you were talking about earlier, Paul.
And we mentioned about the rounds. He's gone 11 rounds with Klitschko once, and he's been in a plethora of 12-round fights. Price never been past seven. Factor or doesn't have anything to do with today's
fight? Well, it can be, and that's the thing I want to find out. What happens? How does his attitude change once he has to reach and find that reserve tank? And, you know, especially if someone's putting pressure to him, especially if someone's hitting him and being successful, he hasn't been exposed to that yet. So those are things that, like I said, that's important as far as his process of education, become a better performer, a growing performer, is learning those and finding out those things and getting into a big fight. And, you know, Michael Grant, like, did against Lennox Lewis, which I always look at that as being, you know, example.
Now, the things to look for early is, I guess, respect. I guess maybe that's the key word early is respect. Will Price get the respect of Thompson early and vice versa? I think, you know, Price lands something big early. Will Thompson go into a shell mode, or will Thompson try to go out and maybe land something early himself?
I think that Thompson will try to set, you know, set the table early and try to get him a little leery. Well, I take that back. I think he's going to, you know, try to make it, you know, I don't want to say it a boring fight, but try to get lure David Price into coming in and walking into some things, maybe clinching, like you said, make it ugly, and then start catching him with some, you know, wide shots.
So you think that's Thompson's big key, is kind of make it ugly? If it's boring, Thompson's in the fight.
I think so. I mean, you know, the fans may not like it, and you know, boxing fans, but if the goal is to win and to break him out of his style, you have to do things like that.
What are your thoughts?
I kind of agree with that. Maybe try and catch Price, try and make him be patient and not want to go for that knockout, which he's accustomed to. So I would have to agree with you on that. Try and get him out of his comfort zone.
Yep.
This, like we said before, just the kickoff of a great, you know, month of end of February into March on the Well TV, March 22nd. We're going to back to Montreal, the Bell Center. Kind of been my home away from home the last few months. Adonis Stevenson in a very dangerous fight, fighting a guy who knocked him out, a guy who's knocked down Andre Ward in Darnell Boone. So that's the kickoff of some great fights in March. We got before that, we have the prize fighter this coming Thursday night. Just some great stuff, Tommy.
Yeah, and then again, you mentioned the 22nd. On the 23rd, we have James DeGilligan, and Chris Eubank Jr. is going to be on that undercard. Another very exciting fighter, obviously the son of Chris Eubank Sr., so a guy to definitely keep an eye on.
Well, we'll be back in just a couple minutes with more great discussion, and David Price, Tony Thompson coming very shortly. Welcome back to the Wealth TV Boxing Studios. I'm Mark Ames, along with former IBF Junior Middleweight Champion Paul the Ultimate Vaden and Tommy Morris. Just a few minutes away, our big fight, our really big fight, 247-pound David Price, 262-pound Tony Thompson. The ring walks are just moments away. What are these guys feeling?
Well, everything that they've put into this, just opportunity, this moment. So now it's check. I didn't shortcut anything. Did I do my road work? Did I get up when I didn't want to? Did I ask for those additional rounds? Basically, did I left no stone unturned? So this is a big moment because it's life-changing for both of them.
I know, as someone who's covered a lot of fights, Tommy, I know you've been very instrumental in getting this fight here on Well TV, all the build-up. A guy like you and I, what are you feeling now?
I'm excited, just like a fighter. I mean, obviously, I can't speak for Paul what it's really like to be walking out of the tunnel like that, but I'm getting the butterflies a little bit now, too. I'm excited to see what this 262 is all about. Is it going to be a slow 262 for Thompson, or is he going to be ready to go?
Price has about 10,000 of I call his best friends cheering him on when he walks out of that tunnel. Does that give you an extra boost, or is that, could that sometimes add the pressure?
That's why I said he has to become a performer and learn how to work with the crowd and know, and I'm not going singer speak, but what songs to play and how to play them, because he doesn't want to go out of who he really is and what his strong attributes are, which can cause him to get knocked out.
And Tony Thompson walk into a hostile environment. What do you think he's thinking at this point?
I think he's already put himself even through training camp in that underdog type of mindset. He's been here before, remember, in the other fights that he's had.
Well, we are ready to begin our festivities live from the Echo Arena in Liverpool, England. Let's get ready. David Price and Tony Thompson.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the waiting is over. It's the big one. Coming to the ring, international heavyweight boxing, from the USA, Tony the Tiger Thompson.
Tony Thompson said that fighting in his opponent's backyard would motivate him. He said he wouldn't be fazed by it, not one bit. Well, he is getting a hostile reception. In a kind of pantomime baddie kind of way. ...41 years old, twice he's fought Vladimir Klitschko and come up short. He's made the right noises in the run-up to this fight, but now we find out, shortly we'll find out if it's all just talk. Incidentally, if you want to get a little bit of a price off, Tony Thompson's 80-1 against winning by first round knockout. David Price, 11-2 against.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here he comes. Liverpool's very own David.
They will now raise the rafters. Once upon a time he dreamed of playing for Liverpool. Now the dream's to be world heavyweight champion. As a kid, he lived just a few yards away from Anfield. I wonder if one day he might fight for the world heavyweight title on that very ground. Likeable fella, David Price, and on Merseyside, every inch, all 6'8", a sporting hero. And what a reception he's getting! Certainly looks as though he means business. Frank Maloney believes that it is Price's destiny to follow in the footsteps of Lennox Lewis. So far, he's not looked too wrong. Thoughts. Been there before, seen it, done it. How much ambition, though, does Tony Thompson still have? Oh, The Echo Arena's ready. Now I think we're heading towards the anthems.
Ladies and gentlemen, could I ask, please, at this time, that you remain standing before the introductions and join us in the respect for both countries with their national anthems. So we start with the national anthem of the United States of America.
The officials are ready. The boxers are ready.
ready? Are you ready for the main event? Introducing, in the blue corner, wearing black shorts, weighing in 18 stone 10 pounds, bringing to the ring a 39 fight record, 36 wins, 24 inside the distance, only 3 defeats. He's a former WBO Intercontinental Champion. He is a 2-times world title challenger. Both times he faced Dr. Steelhammer Vladimir Klitschko. From Washington, D.C. in the USA, Tony the Tiger Thompson. And across the ring in the red corner, wearing the silver grey shorts with red and gold, he weighed in at 17 stone 9 pounds. He brings to the ring a perfect professional record, 15 wins from 15 contests, 13 wins inside the distance, with 12 of those stoppages coming inside 4 rounds or less. He is the reigning heavyweight champion of Great Britain and the Commonwealth. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome home to Liverpool, the undefeated David Price.
Tony Thompson looking a little bit fleshy around the midriff. His heaviest ever in a professional fight. At the age of 41. David Price, as ever, his physique absolutely chiseled. Thompson said that he would be the stronger man and that from the southpaw stance he would boss this fight, that he would control the ring. Right, well, we'll see. Got good names on his record, Thompson, beating the likes of Dominic Quinn, Timur Ibrahimov, Vaughn Bean, Luan Krasniqi, which was a good win over in Hamburg, did him in 5 rounds. That set up his first challenge for a world title, but against Vladimir Klitschko last time out, beaten in 6 rounds, he looked to me, I have to say, as though his best days were very much behind him.
This will be a lot about David trying to get back to his old amateur days on how you deal with the southpaw stance as well. Well, I don't think he's fought any southpaws, very, very few if he has. And
Audley Harrison,
obviously the one round, he never really got anything out of that though, did he? So he's got to try and, you know, manage the style of someone who's actually going to be punching back a lot more than Audley Harrison did as well.
Thompson is a sharp puncher. 24 stoppage wins in his 36 victories. Price has never been past 7 rounds. Some people say he needs rounds under his belt. I'm not sure that David thinks quite that way. If he sees the opportunity, he'll be going for broke from word go. Quite opening, though, to this fight. Just having a look at Thompson. There's the right hand. Just made Thompson blink a little. Price has got a very good jab when he uses it. Been preparing for this with the London cruiserweight, southpaw Wadi Camacho. Put a lot of practice rounds, sparring rounds under his belt. There's a nice jab from Price.
Yeah,
Solid shot to the body from Price.
You can see Thompson's very competent. You know, he's waiting. He's not fazed by any of this. He's obviously been in with the Klitschkos, and you know, he's over there, and he's trying to do that job and trying to come over here and try and mess Price up. It was, and you know, it's a fear and out stage, and Tony Thompson's bringing a lot more than all the Addison did, and the fact that, you know, he is a very competent fighter, but he's not one who's had the past issues of all the Addison, but he's, you know, scared to throw, a bit gun-shy and everything else. So Tony Thompson is there, and he'll be waiting with the sharp counters himself. You know, he's not a light puncher himself, he can dig, so Price has always got to stay switched on, just keep things basic and simple until he sees that opening.
All right. This fella, he's got...
Franny Smith, David Price's trainer.
Just keep it as you're doing. Just professional job, all right? Good lad, come on.
It's after him as an amateur. And still here once more as a pro. Quiet opening round then.
Yeah, it was. Quiet, as I say, feeling out, you know. They'll both warm into the fight a bit more in this round, and David may start seeing a few more openings and letting go of that right arm, which we know is his money punch.
A cagey start from Thompson, not really committing himself. After he made his debut, I know David Price said that he could hear us commentating it here, he could hear me at ringside. Not much chance of that tonight. Some 8,000 here at the Echo Arena.
His debut was in here, wasn't it, John?
Yeah.
Ingleby, was it? Right, I remember it. I remember it being probably one of his toughest fights up until about, until David's like 8 or 9 fight.
Hasn't really been either stunned or hurt as a professional. There are question marks about his chin as an amateur. Oh, there's the right hand looking to unload on Thompson now. And the first big attack of the fight. Big body shots from Price.
Still got to be careful, John. You know, Thompson was looking through the guard there. He looks okay in his head. His eyes look okay. His legs stiffened up off that shot, but he still seemed to have all his senses. He's still looking for the counter.
Price is looking for it now.
Nice.
You can bet your money, Paul, that somewhere the Klitschko brothers will be watching this, and also that a big fellow called Tyson Fury will be watching.
Yep, it's exciting times in this heavyweight to be.
Oh, goodness me! Well, there is the disaster scenario for this huge crowd, and Price is in real trouble. He's on jelly legs, and it's been stopped. It's all over. It has been finished in the second round. Tony Thompson has delivered a tremendous shot. Price caught and defeated. Well, we wondered if he was washed up. We wondered how much he wanted it. There's your answer. And Liverpool is just stunned. The crowd cannot believe what they've seen. David Price, in the second round, knocked out. Stopped on his feet. He was on jelly legs when he got back up.
I don't know how he got back up, John. That was some shot.
Thompson caught him with an absolute peach. Crowd stunned. Let's take another look at how that end came and the shot which Tony Thompson found. Well, a right hand.
Sharp right hook on the side. David has even looking. Just landed right in the side of the neck, just below the ear. just rattled all his senses as soon as it landed. David just about to set himself to throw a right hand, and the sharp right hook just beat him to the punch right on the side of his neck, just below his ear. You know, it's a horrible place to be caught. Just disoriented every sense of David Price, and the legs were gone.
Just been trying to land a big right hand of his own, and there was the reply from Tony Thompson. Well, in his 16th fight, for the first time, defeat for David Price. I suppose there'll be people who will look at this and say, well, he's been badly exposed, but you could also say, great shot from Tony Thompson. And let's not forget as well that early in his career, Vladimir Klitschko was on the canvas many a time.
Yeah, of course. Listen, it was a shot. David set himself to throw a big right hand, and the sharp right who's come round the side, caught him just below his ear, near the area you don't want to be getting caught, you know, right on the chin, as David's throwing a shot, and them shots, they're the ones that catch you and disorientate you and take your legs away from you, and that's exactly what it's done. I don't feel he's been exposed at all.
But he has been defeated, and he can, I think, hardly believe what has happened. Tony Thompson, though, in the other corner, he was written off, and people said, was his career over? And he found the perfect answer to that. At the age of 41, he's still got something left to offer. So the Echo Arena is stunned. And the two fighters being drawn together now by referee Steve Gray. And confirmation will come, and not what we'd any of us expected to hear, but that Tony Thompson in the second round has defeated David Price.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as a referee, Mr. Steve Gray brings both the boxers to the centre of the ring. Please show your appreciation for both boxers. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the end comes 2 minutes and 17 seconds into round number two, when our referee, Mr. Steve Gray, stops the contest in his opinion. David Price in no position to continue. The winner from Washington, Tony the Tiger Thompson.
Well, Thompson getting a pretty sporting round of applause from the big crowd here in Liverpool. You're almost speechless, Paul.
I am. It's just something that you just don't expect. You know, you're seeing kids like David Price come in and steamrolling through good fighters, and it was expected tonight. You know, you're expecting a good shot to land every now and then from Price. The first round was going that way, feeling each other out, but right hand landing, and you just expect the wins to come, and that's what happens when fighters in heavyweight boxing like David Price, you know, right the way through to the top and right the way back in time. You know, the fighters that, like you're saying, Vladimir Klitschko being chinned a few times and dropped a few times, that's heavyweight boxing for you, and that's why it's so exciting, and that's why it draws the crowds in more than any other weight.
So, nobody said it was going to be easy. He's now got to come back from that, Jim.
Well, well, well. This is why, Paul, we call this sport the theater of the unexpected.
That's what I love about this sport is you have an individual who comes in as a huge underdog. He seems like he's on his last leg. As he said, he didn't want to exit this boxing, this great sport as a club fighter. And he gets an opportunity, and truthfully, you're always a punch away from either losing or a punch away from putting yourself right back in a position of something, a positive situation.
Tommy, when you saw him go down, what were your first thoughts?
I was in shock, to be honest with you. Again, a lot of people had this as being a quick fight for David Price to win. No one saw this coming at all. Some people, I know I was chastised a little bit. I thought this fight was going to go a long way. And everyone's like, no, it's going to be a quick one for David. But it was a very quick one in favor of Tony.
Let's talk about the punch for a second. He kind of stepped around, landed a little right, halfway up the neck, kind of around the neck, the ear.
It appeared, like I said, like a wide right hook. And you don't know what you don't know as far as how David Price, when he takes a shot, because he hasn't really had the opportunity. Like I said, that process of that educational process.
And right before, a couple moments before, on the broadcast, they said that there was questions about his chin's amateur, and he really hadn't been tested as a pro. It's been tested now, and came up short on that test.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now the future of the heavyweight division. Now we have another name back in the mix, 41-year-old Tony Thompson. When I was down in D.C. with Thompson, he says he's going to beat Price. Then now he's a viable candidate maybe to fight Vitaly now. And he's going to beat, he told me he wants to beat Vitaly and then right his two wrongs with Vladimir. Thompson, who works down in Washington, D.C., Homeland Security, got to, you know, wait a few more minutes for that not to become a full-time job for him.
Yeah, definitely got to take advantage of this opportunity. This is a huge win for him. Again, everyone's shocked. Guys crossed the pond. I mean, you heard it. The announcers, they were speechless towards the end of that fight. But he's back. He's got his name back in there again.
We talked about the future of the heavyweight division going through England and the United Kingdom with Fury and Price. Now, one's down. They mentioned that Vladimir Klitschko suffered losses, a loss early in his career. What I mean, David Price, what's going through his mind? I mean, maybe right now it probably hasn't set in. Could this be something that defines his career? That, I mean, Aldo Harrison, he got beat early in his career. It seemed like he never recovered from that.
You're never guaranteed that you'll find your way back, and that's how you find out when you lose what happened, especially in this type of situation. Vladimir Klitschko, and I'm just thinking about when he lost to him, he was knocked out by Corey Sanders. It was in this similar fashion that they believe it was a second round knockout or something like that. And he was able to find himself back and improve as a boxer, as a performer. We'll find out. We'll find out if David Price is able to.
Now, Tony Thompson, we mentioned the world's his oyster again.
It's a great story. It's just a great story. Like I said, for you see an individual like this who, like I said, who comes in as a huge underdog, seemed to be as an afterthought, and it's just part of this whole process for David Price as the opponent. It's just a great thing to see a guy have the stick-to-itiveness and to get a victory.
And, you know, being in America, there's been a lot written, a lot said about the American heavyweights. Thompson's come up short twice. We got guys like Areola came up short. Seth Mitchell was supposed to be the next guy in line. He was stopped by Banks, and we got Banks and Steve Cunningham now, even though he's coming off his defeat. He's got a chance a couple weeks to do what Thompson just did. Now, Thompson, if you're his manager, and I know you know the business of boxing, what's the first phone call you're making?
Well, obviously, to get yourself in title contention, and I would go the route the other way as far as Vitaly. I like to make note, do not sleep on Steve Cunningham.
Absolutely.
Because that is a fight that I actually could see him winning against Tyson Fury. I'm serious.
Tommy, what do you think? I mean, we've been featuring Fury. We've been featuring Price now. What do you think?
Well, now I think anything's possible because there's no way I saw that coming at all. I think, as far as Fury Cunningham's concerned, I think Fury's going to be too much for him. But, again, my whole world has been shocked.
We're about 7 weeks into the new year. Already we have an upset of the year candidate.
Absolutely.
And the way it was done, I mean, if someone would have told me, we were talking about if Thompson would have made it an ugly fight and maybe, you know, kind of won an ugly kind of a decision, that would have surprised me. This shocked me.
Well, he wouldn't have won a decision. I'm just saying it would have lured David Price into being open again, caught with something because throwing all caution to the wind. So I thought by making it ugly would cause him to let the crowd lure him into doing something wrong. But now it's like I said, the possibilities are exciting now for the American boxer.
Yeah, we mentioned a whole bunch of times in the opening, he really hasn't gone a long distance. He hasn't really been hit before. Right. He got hit there. So that was the first time we ever saw him get hit, and it didn't work out well for him.
Any final thoughts, Paul?
Well, this is the great thing about the sport of boxing. I'm glad that we were able to see this on Wealth TV, and it shows the possibilities of what can happen when people have the drive, stick-to-itiveness in boxing.
Real quickly, 15 seconds, Tommy, what are we looking for on Wealth TV coming up?
Again, we're looking forward to Prize Fighter heavyweights coming here on Thursday. And then after that, we got Adonis Stevenson, Darnell Boone, James DeGale also on that same weekend. And on that card will also be Chris Eubank Jr. And then afterwards, Bellew Chimbella.
For Tommy Morris and the champ, Paul Vaden, I'm Mark Abrams. We'll see you next time on Wealth TV Fight Night.